the state of Maryland does not revolve around Peter V.R. Francho. So let's start right there. That's not what this is about.
Just a completely reckless, irregular, extraordinary attack, not on me, but on the taxpayers of the state. That's what the legislature's attacking by ripping out the enforcement division from the comptroller's office.
And that was House Economic Matters Committee Chairman Derek Davis and Comptroller Peter Francho on the C4 show today. I'm Robert Lang alongside C4. It is override day
in
Annapolis. One of the bills overridden by the House of Delegates as we speak, Senate's expected to follow suit, takes away enforcement of regulations on alcohol and tobacco from the comptroller,
puts
it in the hand of an independent commission. C4, it sounds like, you know, the Democrats, certain Democrats don't like Comptroller Peter Francho.
Obviously.
He was the top vote getter last year among Democrats.
Well,
statewide.
Listen to Chairman Derek Davis, as I just told you a moment ago. We came into the House delegates together, Derek and I did. Whenever you say somebody's full name, including their middle initials, you're not saying a compliment towards them. So the emphasis that he introduced him should tell you how the legislature feels about this wayward.
Why should people even care about this?
Well, the main reason is because $50 million is a price tag, at least according to the fiscal note, that's attached to the creation of this new task force, something that is a duplication of effort of what the comptroller's office would do in and of its own. And also they should care because the only reason this is being done, Robert, is to retaliate against this comptroller for standing up for the craft brewers and the smaller folks against, we all know in Annapolis, the alcohol beverage industry down there runs everything. The Millers, the Budweisers, the large guys.
The Katzifs.
Exactly.
Who are the beer distributors.
Yes.
You can also talk about, or at least Chairman Davis talks about the fact that it was a Republican who was the chairman of the task force that came up with this bill, Warren Miller of Howard County.
Well, let people who call my show say that while he is a Republican, yes, he's still a member of the legislature. And this is as much a legislature against Peter Francho thing as it is a Democrat or Republican thing. You have a situation where the comptroller for the last few years, Robert, we know this, he's been at the ire of the president of the Senate. He's been at the ire at times of the
Speaker of the House. He campaigned against Mike Miller's primary opponent.
Absolutely. So it coming from the body, and Francho and I served together in the House delegates, he's a former member of the body who the body now looks at, Robert, with disdain. They just do.
Very quickly, let's talk about the minimum wage.
Yes.
And the minimum wage increase to $15 an hour is official because the House and Senate has overridden. Both.
It's a done deal. As we had many small business people, Robert, calling the show, this will definitely mean, I want people to mark this date down, March the 28th of 2019. Let's look at when the $11 hits on January 1st, then the escalator raises to 2025. How many businesses stop hiring? How many businesses cut back hours? And how many small businesses, those 15 and under, Robert, how many shutter their doors? Let's wait and see how this all thing plays out.
To be continued, the C4
Thank
show
you,
back
Robert.
Tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.